In this video, we're going to talk about O-rings in dental implants and attachments, and in particular, different O-ring sizes. Challenges of dental implants and attachments is figuring out what size O-ring you need. Can you talk me through the process here?
Absolutely. A lot of the time you don't even need to remove the O-ring from the housing to determine what size you need. We have a couple really nice tools for you. First, you do need to get an accurate measurement. When we take a look at an O-ring abutment, there's two measurements we take a look at. The first is the neck of the ball or the undercut area where the O-ring sits. Mm-hmm. On this case, for example, we're measuring a 1.4.
Okay.
In general, there's about a 0.4 to 0.8 millimeter drop between the height of contour and the retention zone. So if we measure a 1.4 retention zone, our height of contour, which is the diameter of the ball, most of the time is in that 1.8 to 2.2 millimeter range.
Which is what keeps the O-ring down, as it were.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. This one is a 2.15. So if you had measured a 2.15 diameter ball and said, I need an O-ring for it, I would do that math, 0.4 to 0.8, and know something in that 1.4 range would be ideal. Mm-hmm. This is where a couple tools we have for you are going to be really nice. In our product catalog, on our app, and also on the website is an O-ring size chart. It has five different sizes of O-rings, shows the outer diameter and the internal diameter. You take the diameter of the retention zone, match that with the internal diameter of the O-ring, you're done searching.
Now you know what your size is.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Now, I also understand that getting a caliper like this into the mouth is not something that's easy to do.
It doesn't look mouth-friendly, sure.
No. And a lot of times, Bully gauges are used, but those are not as accurate as we want them to be. So one of the other options is we have an O-ring combo pack. Five different sizes, two O-rings of each size, and instead of wasting your chairside time or your time in the laboratory trying to measure and guess, you can use this just to try them on, till you find the size that fits.
And it's pretty easy to pop them on and off. Can you show us how that works?
Sure. So we have two different styles of housings we see. One is the opener donut style housing. Mm-hmm. It's much lower profile, takes less space.
You just popped it on right there. It's that quick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of movement.
Okay.
The only negative to the donut style housing is that you need to block out the head or the top of the post during processing.
Okay.
If you imagine this inside of a denture and there's acrylic on top, the first time the patient functions or bites down, and there's that movement, because O-rings are the most resilient attachment. It's why they're used on mini implants. They're resilient, they provide a lot of movement, they help protect your abutments. So the first time the patient functions and had bit down on this, that post is going to come through the O-ring and hit acrylic. So we need to have some free space in there to allow that post to move through the O-ring without making contact with the acrylic and causing a fracture.
Right.
So the donut style, while it takes less space, you do need to block out more.
Okay.
The second style, and these are more popular and easier sometimes, are the full domed housings. As you can see, they take up a lot more space, but for a chairside pickup, you don't need to do this block out.
Right.
So it makes them a lot easier. Now, going back to the donut style, if you block out the head with plaster, a slurry mix of plaster, you can just take your water afterwards and cold rinse it right out of there. It's a nice, easy cleanup. It's a lot easier than soft wax. But again, we probably see a lot of more of the closed-top housings used.
All right, cool. Is that everything we need to know about O-ring in particular? O-ring sizing?
Yes, it is, Tim.
Take some time, think it through.
Yes, sir.
If you'd like more information, please head on over to preat.com where you'll find lots of knowledge and information. Of course, you'll be able to order all of these products. There are several hundred case presentations as well as the product book. If you'd like to get in touch with us, particularly our technical team or our customer service, please call our 1-800 number or jump in, email us, use our contact form, all of that available on preat.com.